Good afternoon. Welcome to St. Sebastian.
Hold us in your mercy. 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 Maker's love poured out from heaven. Mercy's word made flesh among us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Thank you. We gather on this, the fifth Sunday of our Lenten season, a week away from the beginning of Holy Week, and so we gather once more on this Lenten journey to be challenged by the Lord in the Scriptures proclaimed and then nourished by the gift of His grace in this Holy Eucharist. To prepare our hearts, let us first be mindful of our sinfulness and together call upon Him for His mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
And let us pray. By your help, we beseech you, Lord our God. May we walk eagerly in that same charity with which, out of love for the world, your Son handed himself over to death. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant I made with their fathers, the day I took them from the hand to lead them forth from the land of Egypt. For they broke my covenant, and I had to show myself their master, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel After those days, says the Lord, I will place my law within them and write it upon their hearts. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer will they have need to teach their friends and their relatives how to know the Lord. All, from at least to the greatest, shall know me, says the Lord. For I will forgive their evil doing and remember their sin no more. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. In the days when Jesus Christ was in flesh, he offered prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverence. Son, though he was, he learned obedience from what he suffered. And when he was made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. be with you.
And with
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Some Greeks who had come to worship at the Passover feast came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and asked him, "Sir, we would like to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew. Then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it, and whoever hates his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also my servant will be. The Father will honor whoever serves me. I am troubled now, yet what should I say? Father, save me from this hour. But it was for this purpose that I came to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven, "I have glorified it and will glorify it again." The crowd there heard it and said it was thunder, but others said, "An angel has spoken to him." Jesus answered and said, "This voice did not come for my sake, but for yours. Now is the time of judgment on this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And when I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw everyone to myself." He said this, indicating the kind of death he would die. The Gospel of the Lord. For those who may not be familiar with the change in the liturgical scenery here, the covering of the statues and the cross and the icons takes place at the beginning of Passiontide. This goes back centuries in the church. It is now that the readings of the church begin to focus on the religious leaders rejecting Jesus and moving him to his death. And so the church begins to mourn this reality of what's unfolding in the life of Christ in the final days before his death. And so the images, we fast from the holy images until the Easter Vigil, when we announce that Christ is risen. "Sir, we would like to see Jesus," our gospel begins. We're in the 12th chapter of John, and Greeks who are coming up for the Passover, and the word Greeks kind of indicates that they're probably not Jews, they're probably Gentiles. And they've come up to the Passover feast. Maybe they're thinking about becoming Jews or entering into the celebration of the great Jewish feast as everyone is gathering at the temple. But they approach Philip. "Sir, we would like to see Jesus." And no wonder. They must have heard all about him, because just prior to this, Jesus has risen Lazarus from the dead. He called Lazarus from the tomb. "Lazarus, come forth." His dear friend, the greatest of the miracles of Jesus, overwhelming death itself. No wonder they want to see him. He's the one who cleared the temple as nobody would or dare to do. And now that he's risen his friend from the dead, the word is out, and Jesus has entered into Jerusalem, and we hear of some that are tracking him down. We want to see him. Jesus' response is kind of an obtuse response. When Philip and Andrew go to him and say they want to see you, his response is really, it's not about seeing me. It's ultimately about knowing me and being willing to follow me. Because Jesus then speaks of his impending death. He says, "A grain of wheat is nothing until it falls to the ground and produces much fruit." Jesus is speaking of his own sacrifice. And then he has the audacity to say, "I want my followers to do the same. Are you willing to let go of your lives and all that we hold on to
for the sake of the kingdom, for the sake of understanding what a sacrificial life means, what sacrificial love is, what true mercy is all about. Because something new is taking place, and we get a glimpse of that in our first reading from the prophet Jeremiah. We're in chapter 31 of Jeremiah, and Jeremiah is the prophet in Jerusalem as it's being destroyed, as the temple is being torn apart. 600 years before the birth of Christ. And Jeremiah says a new covenant is going to be established, a new relationship with God that's not going to be carved on stone like the Ten Commandments, but rather set in everyone's heart. And Jesus is the revelation of that. Jesus is that new covenant. And remember, we began Lent, the second Sunday of Lent, up on Mount Tabor, the transfiguration and the glory of God revealed in Jesus, who is dazzling white, with Moses and Elijah at each side. And the voice of God says, "This is my beloved Son, listen to him." Not just see him, but listen to him. A moment of grand glory, the power and radiance of God revealed on the mountaintop. But there's one more mountaintop now that Jesus must climb. One more episode for God's glory to be revealed. And it's not an act of glory that we normally associate with glory. It's going to be his crucifixion. As he ascended Mount Tabor and was revealed in all his glory, he soon will be forced to climb Golgotha and be nailed to a cross. And it's here where the Father says, "My glory will be revealed again." The power of God, revealed not only in radiance and power, but in the offering of the life of his only begotten Son. And as we move now into this Lenten season and see the world turning against Jesus, Jesus comes to his followers and all those who want to see him, and says, "Will you do the same? Will you do the same?" It's not about seeing Jesus. It's about coming to know him. And it's not just about coming to know him. It's about making a decision in one's life to say, "I will follow him. I will live my life as a disciple. And I will offer my life as a sacrifice for the sake of the kingdom of God." And whatever that might mean in each of our lives might be something different, but it comes down to the power allowing God's glory to be revealed in us by us making that decision to say, "Christ is my Lord and Savior, and he's offered his life for us, and I'm willing to follow him. Not just look for him, but discover him in my life and follow him." And that's why we come here. We come here just not to see Jesus. We come here to hear him speak to us in Scripture. We come here to allow him to nourish us with the gift of his body and blood from this holy altar, so that we too can have the courage to allow ourselves to be instruments of God's glory revealed in the sacrifices we make in service to one another.
Next week is Passion Sunday. We shall follow the Lord to the cross. The question for us is, are we really, truly willing to do that, or to just hear a story once again told? Let us pray for the grace and the strengthening of our faith, to have the courage to not just see Jesus, but to hear him and follow. In our final week of prayers for those who will be joining us in the Catholic Church at the Easter Vigil, it's a perfect set of readings, because the three of them have come not only to see Jesus, but they've learned about him, and they've made a decision to say, "Yes, we want to join the community of disciples in following him." So I ask Mona now to call them forward for the final prayers over them before their initiation.
Ashton Collegius, please come forward with your sponsor, Leslie Bozek. Nicholas Rosa, Rizzo, please come forward with your sponsor, Katie Marcinek.
Let us pray for these elect whom God has chosen. May the grace of the sacraments conform them to Christ in his passion and resurrection, and enable them to triumph over death. God, not of the dead, but of the living, you sent your Son to proclaim life, to snatch us from the realm of death, and to lead us to the resurrection. Free these elect from the power of the spirit of evil, so that they may bear witness to their life in the risen Christ, for he lives and reigns forever and ever. Lord Jesus, you said, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Grant that we may die to ourselves and be born into the light through your death and resurrection. Free from the grasp of death those who await your life-giving sacraments, and deliver them from the spirit of corruption. Through your Spirit who gives life, fill them with faith, hope, and charity, that they may live with you always in the glory of your resurrection. For you are Lord forever and ever. Amen. Let us stand now to bring our prayers to the Lord.
For the church, may our Lenten observance call us to serve others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our hearts and in our world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace to appreciate family, relationships over earthly treasures, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those preparing for full reception into the Catholic Church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering from loneliness and the sick, may they know God's love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Jean Oshevsky and May K. Kelly, sister of Karen Sadler, may they rejoice with all the angels and the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, hear the prayers of your daughters and sons as we draw to the close of this holy season to prepare our hearts to celebrate the Easter sacraments. Come to us now and give us the courage of faith that we need to follow your Son, and we make these prayers through Christ our Lord. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Hear us, Almighty God, and having instilled in your servants the teachings of the Christian faith, graciously purify them by the working of the sacrifice through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
With
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Sebastian, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that we may always be counted among the members of Christ in whose body and blood we have communion, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. A couple of announcements. This coming Friday evening will be our last Friday evening for the Stations of the Cross at 7 p.m. here in the church. Next Tuesday evening from 5:30 till 7:30 p.m., Father Fisher and I will be here in the church to hear confessions. We had a nice turnout on Thursday evening. If you've not yet prepared for the Holy Week, it'd be a great opportunity this Tuesday evening, 5:30 to 7:30 p.m. here in the church. We are in the search process for a new youth minister. If you know someone who might be interested in the position, please let them know, and please pray that our search process will be a fruitful one. The Holy Week schedule, starting with Palm Sunday next week through Easter, is listed in the weekend bulletin. We're asking you to please sign up for Palm Sunday and the Easter Masses, so please go to the parish website or your parish app and sign up for next weekend's Masses, Saturday and Sunday, and Easter Sunday, Easter weekend as well. If you've not yet turned in your CSA pledge card, please, we invite you to do so. Many parishioners have turned them in, which has been great, but we still have a ways to go to get to our goal, so before you leave for spring break, fill out that little card and drop it in the mail to us. Please bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Bless, O Lord, your people who long for the gift of your mercy, and grant that what at your prompting they desire, they may receive by your generous gift through Christ our Lord. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Amen.